Charles Barkley says he roots against all super teams. These quotes are lengthy, but they're really good. I'm going to read them to you. I think it's worth hearing it all. Charles says, I'm not a fan of super teams. So listen, if they win it, they win it, speaking of the Nets. But to be perfectly clear, I'm rooting against those guys. I root against all super teams. If I'd known you guys were going to make fun of me for not winning a championship, I would have joined a super team back in my day. Me and Patrick Ewing and Karl Malone and John Stockton. But I feel good about my legacy. I'm pretty sure Patrick and John and Carl do too. LeBron started this super team thing in Miami, and hey, it's the way the game is played now. To go back to my day, even though we didn't win the championship, the Sixers were worth watching. The Knicks were worth watching. The Pacers were worth watching when Reggie was there. Same thing with Atlanta and Dominique. I just don't think it's good for business. But these young kids, they all fold to peer pressure and feel like they've got to win a championship or their life sucks. Fascinating quotes from Charles Barkley, because I think there's so much in that to unpack. First of all, as one who came of age loving this sport in the 70s and then very much so in the golden age, which were the 80s and the 90s, he's talking about all-time great players who never won a championship. And you can say it's because Michael's teams kept beating them all, but they all got there and they all knocked on the door. Charles played him in the finals. Ewing played him tough as hell in the playoffs. It felt like almost every single year. And obviously Stockton and Malone played him in the finals in back-to-back years, and both those series went six. They had chances to win. Charles went six games in the finals in 93 with Michael. So they had chances to win, and they don't. Somewhere along the line, it became all about either you win the championship or your career is a bust. I'm not sure when that happened because it wasn't the case then. I do sort of feel like I need to raise my hand because I wonder if Mike and Mike had played some role in that. Because I think what happened was when the LeBron versus Michael, and maybe even before that, when the Kobe versus Michael debate started happening, I think that's when we started counting rings. Like, we weren't counting Larry's rings and Magic's rings. You knew that Russell had all those rings just because there were so ridiculously many of them. But we didn't count all the other best players in the NBA in the 70s, John Havlicek, Rick Barry, name whoever you want, Kareem, Elvin Hayes. We didn't sit around and count their championships as a way of determining how great they were. We never talked about Ted Williams and Ernie Banks as being anything other than all-time great players, even though they never won World Series. Winning championships didn't have to be the be-all, end-all. And then all of a sudden it was. And the conversation around the sport became, I think, the motivating factor for that. And in that regard, I cannot blame these guys for feeling as though, like, if I'm sitting in their shoes, I can see where I might say, so you're criticizing me for putting myself in the best position to win a championship, but then if I don't win a championship, you're going to say, well, he never reached his potential, or his career is on some level a failure, or whatever it is, he isn't all that great because he never won. Well, which is it? I get that. I get players feeling that way. It doesn't make me hate super teams any less, but I understand it. I'm not sure exactly what can be done about it. We need to find a way to go back to the other way. And we're never stopping the counting of the rings. The counting of the rings is now with us. That's never going to stop. So we have to figure out a way to combat the super team phenomenon without hoping that that will go away.